हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ राहुल पाटिल एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज़ स्पेसिफिक स्पीड एंड प्राइमिंग ऑफ द पंप। सो द स्पेसिफिक स्पीड इन सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप इज़ द स्पीड ऑफ जियोमेट्रिकल सिमिलर पंप विच वुड डिलीवर 1 क्यूबिक मीटर ऑफ लिक्विड पर सेकेंड अंडर द हेड ऑफ 1 मीटर, मीन्स 1 मीटर क्यूब पर सेकेंड अगेंस्ट द हेड ऑफ 1 मीटर। And definitely, the head against which the centrifugal pump has to do the work is manometric head. And this specific speed is given by specific speed capital M suffix x is equal to n under root q upon hm 3 raised to 3 by 4, hm raised to 3 by 4, where n is the RPM, this q is 1 meter cube per second, that is discharge or flow rate, and this HM is 1 meter, that is a manometric head. Now, what is the derivation of the specific speed that we are going to study? We know that the discharge through the pump is given by circumferential area, that is pi into d into b into flow velocity. So it's a pi d b v upon 1. From this equation, we can say that this Q is directly proportional to the diameter, width, and the flow velocity if you take this pi as a constant. Then, if you take this width and this width and this diameter of the particular wheel or impeller is directly proportional to each other, then we can take this B is equal to D, and we can write Q is directly proportional to d square into Vm. Because to do the similar design in pump, we have to consider whatever the increasing proportion of the diameter, in the same way we have to increase the width also. Means any turbo machine, the width and diameter can increase proportionally with each other, so that we are getting the proper design of the pump or turbine or e-turbo machine at inlet and outlet. Now, we will get the equation Q directly proportional to the D square into V of 1, V of, that is equation number 1. Now, we know that U is equal to pi d n upon 60. So, from this equation, if you take this pi and 60, pi by 60 are constant, then we can write this U directly proportional to the D n. U directly proportional to the dn. Also this u is directly proportional to the vf and directly proportional to the under hm also, because we know that this u is directly proportional to vf. Okay, now from this vf or v at inlet, we know that v is equal to vf1. We can write under root 2g hm or under root 2gh. In this case, in the pump, it is only 2gh m. So, we can write this U directly proportional to Vf and directly proportional to under root hm. Okay. So, why this flow velocity is directly proportional to U? Because U is a tangential velocity, and according to the speed, actually this at the inlet of the turbine, this V1 is equal to Vf1. So, whatever the drawing speed or suction speed of that particular water is depend upon this tangential speed of the impeller. So, U must be the directly proportional to Vf1 or Vf, and from this equation we can say this U directly proportional to Vf and directly proportional to under root hm, that is equation number 2. Now, from equation number 1 and from equation number 2, or from this equation U directly proportional to dn and U directly proportional to the under root hm, we can say this dn and this under root hm are directly proportional to the each other. So d can be written as directly proportional to under root hm upon n, means you would just shift this n on this side. So we will get equation number 3. Now put the value of equation number 2 and equation number 3 in equation number 1. So this equation number 2 and equation number 3 we have to put in equation number 1. So q is directly proportional to the, means d directly proportional to under root hm, so you have to just put the under root hm n whole square, so it is a hm upon n square into under root hm. So u directly proportional under root hm, so we have to just put the value vf ka either, we have to just put this vf under root hm. Now you will get the q value is q is equal to, if you remove the proportionality sign here, we'll get the q is equal to any constant k hm raised to 3 by 2 upon n square, means hm power 1 by 2 here, and this is a 1, so 1 plus 1 by 2, it's hm 3 by 2, so n square, equation number 4. Now take, as per the definition of the specific speed, the hm must be the 1 meter and the q must be the 1 meter cube per second, so and n must be the ns, whatever this rpm must be the ns as per definition of the specific speed. By putting this value, you will get the value of constant over here, what is that, k is equal to n square, and put the equation number 4, this k value over here, we will get the q is equal to n square into hm raised to 3 by 2 upon n square, so ns is equal to n under root q hm raised to 3 by 4. This is the required equation for the specific speed. In the similar way, we can derive the equation for the turbines also. Now, what is the priming of the centrifugal pump, which is a very important one. The operation of the filling of the casing, impeller and suction pipe and the portion of the delivery pump up to delivery valve is called as a priming. Initially, what is happening when pump is going to start, we can directly see the figure over here, okay. When pump is going to operate, initially there is a air in the casing and we have to just transfer the water over here, and due to the air presence in the casing or in the impeller side, it is not able to transfer the liquid from sump level to the delivery point because we cannot get that much pressure over here, okay. So initially main function is that to remove the air from this particular casing, because you have to create a suction pressure. Suction pressure means below atmospheric pressure, means what, it's near to the vacuum, and for the vacuum we need to remove the initial air from this particular casing. So what exactly we are doing, we are just maintaining the pressure level, so we are just initially filling of this particular casing suction pipe to the delivery valve by using of some external water, so all air will be removed from this particular casing. Now once you start the impeller rotating, then everywhere there is a water and the enough suction pressure is created, so water get transferred from this one point to the initially from sump level to the casing, then casing to the delivery pipe. So main function of the priming to remove the pressure over here and to make the continue flow. So this is the second point in the centrifugal pump.